Hey, what is up, YouTube? My name is Eton. Welcome back to another video. This isn't a normal Minecraft Pixelmon video or anything like that, but I am on the Pixelmon mod website. They have just released the new Pixelmon launcher, and they've sort of made it a lot better and a lot easier to use. And yeah, I've made a Pixelmon launcher video when it came out, like when it first came to the public back when I think it was Pixelmon 3.4, not gonna lie. I can go back and check the video, but I still get comments on that video today, like present day. I still get comments on that video, and I was just waiting to see if they would ever update the Pixelmon launcher to make it easier to download and things like that. So I'm gonna show you guys how to download it, except I'm gonna download it with you. I've completely wiped it all away from my computer after being downloaded. I'm having none of it. I've completely uninstalled everything, so what we're going to do, we're all going to download it together. I already have it downloaded on my desktop, but I'm just going to show you how to download it. You go on the Pixelmon Mod website. This link will obviously be in the description below. You head over to Downloads, then you will see this, and the new Pixelmon 4.0.5 update. That video I've already made, that will be in the description below as well. And here you have Pixelmon Launcher 1.1.23. And that was released June 9th, even though I'm recording this on June 8th. So that's hilarious. Yeah, you don't need a forge, and the changelog is here. You can read up the changelog if you want. There are some pretty cool new things that were added and changed, new features and things like that. They just made it a lot easier and a lot more clean, too. So, yeah. So what we're going to do, you're going to head over to whichever link you want. I personally did this first link. It was an ad focus link. Yeah, don't click this, don't click this, don't click anything until you see this please wait chime down and you see the skip button. And as you can see here, I'm not sure whose video this is, but it's someone's video here, it's not mine. And you're gonna wait right here, don't click anything else, and you're just gonna wait, and you're gonna wait, and then you're gonna click download Pixelmon launcher. I already downloaded it, so I don't have to worry about it. And yeah, I'm not sure if this works, if this is compatible with Mac, but I know 100% it works with Windows. So as you can see here, Pixelmon launcher, let's double click this bad boy, let's run it, and it's gonna prepare, checking for a newer version, no newer version, and you can change this to wherever you want, if you want it to be somewhere different, like if you want it on your desktop or something. But yeah, program files, Pixelmon launcher, just keep it there, and we'll go to next. Have main feature installed. It takes about 17 megabytes on your whatever drive it is. It's really not a lot, pretty easy stuff. And yeah, let's click install. It may take a few minutes, maybe a few seconds. Hopefully it doesn't take that long. And as you can see, Pixelmon Launcher is now on my desktop as a shortcut. And I think it will load up. Yep, there we go. It's loaded up, which is great. And now, since I've previously used Pixelmon Launcher, I'm already sort of logged in here, as you can see here. So what you're gonna wanna do, you're gonna wanna log in. Is there a way I can log out? I can log out right here. Okay, just like that, I signed back in, and yet I still have this thing here, so is there a way I can delete this? Browse profile, finder, configure Pixelmon, configure profile. What would this bring up? Oh, that just brings up something over here that I don't need to worry about, so okay. Let's see what this does. Configure profile, what does that do? Okay, so that just configures your profile. So this is your profile editor. Let's delete all my profiles. There we go. So now this is sort of what you should see after you log in. Let's create a new profile. What can we call this new profile? Let's just call it Pixelmon Swagger. Let's call it that, Pixelmon Swagger. And then it will obviously show you which Pixelmon you need. And on it has Pixelmon 3.4, Pixelmon 4.0.4, and then Pixelmon 4.0.5 with this little thing next to it. I'm not really sure what that means. Might be it's an automatic. It already has the forge in it. And it, yeah, it gives us the force that we actually need to play it, which is awesome. But it says this Pixelmon version supports Forge versions blank and above, so we can obviously go for this one. So if you see these symbols, make them go together, and then you can obviously add mods if you want. Let's save it. Now we have Pixelmon Swagger right here. I'm not sure if that was too fast for you guys. Maybe you guys want to pause the video, go back. And yeah, you can obviously change your sound settings up here. It's the Pixelmon launcher music in the background. And obviously you have the Pixelmon website thing, the donate, the servers, the settings, things like that. And yeah, that's you can also create more profiles by clicking this. And then your configure profile is just configuring this. And yeah, basically you're just going to click install. And hopefully everything runs smoothly. That would be fantastic if everything did run smoothly. Not sure how long this should take. It might take a while for some people, and some people might take, you know, not a long time. But it's downloading. It does look like it's going to take a while. So, yeah, I might just speed this up. I'm gonna keep recording it. I'm just going to speed up all of it. Yeah, it does look like it's going to take a while. I'm just going to speed it up. And, yeah, I will see you guys when it's done, I guess. Yeah. Alright, this is almost done. Oh, validating. Oh, copying. Downloading. Okay, so now it's installing Forge. That literally took, I want to say it's 15 minutes for me. Like, I took a shower in between that time, guys. Like, not gonna lie. Like, yeah, I also got, like, a drink of water. Talked to my brother and stuff. But yeah, now it's just installing some libraries. I think this is where it was that was the issue. The library issue was the issue with the previous Pixelmon launcher, because something with the libraries didn't add up or something, and people just could not use the launcher. So hopefully that fixed. And I know that there were a lot of bugs about that, and there was some stuff on the forums about that. So it looks like those libraries are done. The assets are coming in now. Run Pixelmon Swagger. Successfully involved. Alright. Installed. Alright, let's run. And okay, and this is like the console. Pretty cool. It's opening stuff up. Setting. Alright. The version. And there we go. It's opening. It's that easy, guys. It's that easy. They changed it. They made it better. Alright. So yeah, we can obviously add more mods back at that profile editor if we do want to add more mods. I could honestly play my Pixelmon Origin series with the Pixelmon launcher now. That's awesome. Yeah, hopefully that server goes up to 4.0.5, like, you know, yeah. So yeah, hopefully this works. Hopefully there's no bugs. It might be laggy. I might have to change some settings around. But yeah, that's probably well. Okay, there we go. And yeah, pretty cool. Pretty cool. FOV, definitely Quake Pro. Actually, I like it at 90. I like it a smooth 90. I don't like Quake Pro. Skin customization, yeah, whatever. Music and sounds, let's just no. There we go. And you can sort of change your settings around, add your more mods that you want. There we go. Pixelmon, Forge, all this beautiful, beautiful stuff. You can have more multiplayer servers. Up. Oh, okay, don't worry about that. Single player, let's create a new world. Let's call it that. Any world options? Okay, create new world. And now we can play Pixelmon 4.0.5 with the Pixelmon launcher, guys. And obviously, if you're seeing this in the future, where maybe 0.6 is out, or maybe even Pixelmon 5 is out, or something like that. Yeah, thank you. I hope you enjoyed this video. It worked for me. Hopefully it works for you. If you have any questions, definitely let me know in the comment section below. I will try and answer all of them that I can. If I was too fast, try and slow down the video or something. Yeah, that's pretty much it. And it's kind of not responding. Kind of a bit laggy. Probably just because it's brand new. Got to change some settings around. It's like new shoes. You got to break them in, you know? Alright, which starter should we pick? We're obviously going to go Cyndaquil. Alright, it's a bit laggy here. I might have to just change some settings around or something. Alright, so I recommend changing your settings before you go into the Minecraft game. So I think that might be what the issue is. Yeah, it's not responding. Uh-oh. Uh-oh. It's really laggy. Okay, and we're spawning. It's pretty laggy right now. Okay. Alright. Okay. There we go. So I recommend, guys, changing your settings before you actually go into the game. I think that's what might be the problem here. Maybe it might be like the render distance or something like that. Just not responding. All right, here we go. All right, let's do this game. Load it, game. All right, I'm now at my settings. I didn't actually even press escape. So, yeah. All right, guys. I think I know what the issue is. First thing you gotta do, you gotta go to settings. Completely exit out of any Minecraft thing that you're in. Go to your settings, you want to then find your Java arguments. What this means right here, this XMX1024M is the amount of RAM allocated to this. So what we're going to do, depending on your computer and how much it can handle, this means it's 1 gigabyte of RAM. My computer can handle a lot, so let's quickly change this. It's multiples of 1024. So what's multiples of 1024? 2048, that is. So it's 2048, so that's 2 gigabytes right there. I'm not sure. Yeah, that's nothing. And check now. Software's up to date. All right. And okay. I think that should be it. Because that should be it. Let's see if that's saved. So it did save. So now let's go back in and see if it's laggy or not. All right. So what I've been doing, it's working. Just changing the RAM of it, and it's working. It's just that there is a little bit of frame lag. I'm not really sure why that is, but it does work. So if you guys can figure it out, definitely tell me in the comment section below. You'll get a shout out, and I'll probably notice you and maybe in another update video that I make, because I'm literally just doing this brand new, just like you guys are. And yeah, just another thing, I didn't actually start with a starter. It didn't give me a starter. So Pixelmon devs, if you're watching, they didn't give me a starter. So yeah, I will see you guys. If you guys enjoyed, hit that like button. If it helps you in any way, hit that like button. Subscribe if you're new. Hopefully we can get this right somehow. My name is Eton. I'll see you guys for another PixelmonWan video.